Over the past year, I've seen a few Facebook ads that told me that I didn't need a website to run my online business. And while that might be true, it's a lot like saying that I don't need a stove to cook dinner. Sure, I mean, that's true. I can make dinner without a stove. I can use my Instant Pot. I could make a campfire in my backyard. I could eat a cold dinner. There are some other options. But most of the time, it's easier to make dinner when you have a stove. And there's no reason to handicap yourself if you have access to a stove. Well, having a website for your business is just the same thing. It's going to make the process of running and growing your business just a whole lot easier. You'll get a lot better results with a website than you would without it. So if you have the resources to do so, why not? In order to build your business website, first you'll need to purchase your domain. So just decide what you want the domain to be, and then you can buy it from any number of different sites, including Google Domains, GoDaddy, or whatever service you're using to host your website. I personally use and recommend SiteGround, both for hosting a website and for buying your domain, because they have great customer service, reliable website hosting, and affordable rates. Once you have your domain, you're going to need to decide what you want to have on your site. A lot of people overcomplicate this, but really most websites only need about 5 main pages. First, you'll need a homepage. That's the page that people first see when they visit your website. Then, if you're selling something on your site, you'll need a shop page. You'll also maybe want a blog page if you're going to be regularly posting content on your website. This can help with SEO, even if you're not planning to blog every single week. Then you'll want to have an about page so that you can tell people who you are and what you do. And finally, you'll want a contact page so that people can connect with you. There are many different tools you can use to build your website, but the two that I would recommend are WordPress and Squarespace. And trying to decide between these two really comes down to your personality more than anything else. If you are more of the sort of person who likes to figure things out and really understand how things work and wants to customize things to your exact specifications, and you're willing to invest the time and effort to do so, then WordPress is going to be the best option for you. On the other hand, if you want this to be done as quickly and easily as possible, you're fine with maybe cutting a few corners and getting 80% of the results for 20% of the effort, then Squarespace will be your better option. Now, like I said, there are lots of different options out there, so you might be considering using a different service, and that's totally fine. But whatever service you are considering, just make sure that it meets these three most important qualifications. The first one is that it is easy enough for you. If you pick a service that's too hard, so for example, if you choose WordPress, even though you don't really want to invest the time and effort to figure out how to work it, then you're going to be continually frustrated and you will probably not update your website as often as you should because you don't want the hassle. So make sure you pick something that's easy enough for you. Second, your website service and hosting needs to be fast. Really. Not just because we're all impatient, because we're all impatient, but not because you're impatient, because everyone on the internet is impatient. And so if your website loads even slightly slowly, then Google is going to really dock your ranking. Basically, you won't rank on Google very well because Google thinks your website is trash. Both Squarespace or using SiteGround to host WordPress are going to check this box. And then third, if you're using your website for business, you need to make sure that whatever tool you pick can give your website a professional appearance. Squarespace definitely checks this box. WordPress can, if you know what you're doing. If you don't, then you might end up with a very outdated looking website that never looks very professional. But again, if you're willing to invest the time, then you can definitely make WordPress look very professional. Beyond these three most important features, there are a couple other things you'll want to consider. One of them is price. How much can you afford to spend on your website? Squarespace plans start at about $16 per month, or I believe $12 per month if you're paying annually, whereas WordPress is actually free, but you're going to have to pay for hosting. Hosting starts at around $3 or $4 per month, but typically after you end the promotional period with your hosting company, which might be after the first 1 to 2 years, then you're going to be paying more like $12 to $20 per month. The other thing you'll want to consider is just any specific features that are important to you. So maybe you really want to have a slideshow on your website, or you really want to be able to have people purchase things on your website, or for there to be a quiz on your website. And you need to just figure out if the website option that you are considering will give you that possibility. If you're choosing WordPress, pretty much anything is possible, but it might require a paid plugin or some coding. On the other hand, if you choose Squarespace, they've got a lot of different options. You're probably covered, but they don't have everything. And then if you're choosing some other option, well, you're just gonna have to do your research and make sure you figure that out before you sign up and invest a bunch of time into building your site. So personally, my website is built on WordPress, both because I'm definitely the kind of person who likes to tinker with stuff, but also because I first built my website around 10 years ago and Squarespace didn't exist back then. So WordPress was my only option. And I've just continued to build on that platform ever since and expand my website and add more plugins to it, and it serves my purposes really well, but I definitely have a big appreciation for Squarespace as well, just because it is so simple. So because a lot of the time I do recommend Squarespace, I wanted to give it a try and make sure that it was really as simple and easy and amazing as people had told me it was. So I thought we could do that right now.
Okay, so the first thing I did was I actually created my account, and now I'm going to click this button to create a new website. I created another one that I was tinkering around with a little bit, but I want to show you guys how this is working. So it doesn't really matter what we say the site is about, so I'll just say education. And then let's say that we are just trying to do something simple. Let's say market myself or my business. And we're just turning a project into a hobby or hobby into a business. And so then we're going to choose a template here. One of the things I like the most about Squarespace is definitely how all of their templates look so good, just out of the box without even hardly having to do anything. So let's give this one a try. And we're going to call it Pat's Puppy Place. Here's the page. You can click the edit button on this page to start moving stuff around. You can also go to the pages section to be able to get rid of pages or add new pages. Right here, this adds them to the navigation, so this menu. Whereas down here, you can also create pages that aren't linked there. So if you want a page that you're going to get to from another link, or maybe it's a private page, or it's like your terms and services or something like that. So let's say we wanted to add a page that says about us. So we're going to choose a page layout here. Let's choose this one right here. And so we're going to call this About Us. It's really easy to change anything you want. You just hit that edit button and then you click on the section you want to change. Like right here, I could change this button to say something different. Find out more. And then I could change the size of the button if I wanted to a smaller button or a larger button. I can click that edit button and I could change the background to be a different picture. Let's say I chose this picture right here. So then you can control the section height. So I'd probably want the large section height so that we can see the right part of the picture and where that content is on it. I'd probably want it in the middle. I like it over on the side here. You can either just see the image or you can have this dark overlay here. And of course, like you could link each of these things. You can change the text is what I want to say. You can just edit every part of the page. You can hook this up and connect it to your email service, or you can just use it inside of Squarespace. You can change the footer and change what links are down here as well. And so you can make these ones say something different, and you could also make them link to different pages of your site. So just like this, change where they're linking to. So it's really easy to change the menus and just everything about it. So like we were talking about earlier, the main pages that I would recommend you have on your site are the About Us page. They had the Our Mission page already, which is really, that is the same thing. And then the services or the shop page. We don't need this Get Involved page. And then we have the blog page. And then the only other one that we would need would be some sort of contact page. On this website, they've got this Donate Now page, but we could just change this really easily. We could really easily add a form onto this page. We can choose the form layout we want. So if I wanted, I could just delete this whole top section And then now this page is just this contact form. And so these are what the rates are right now.
Personally, I found Squarespace really easy to use, and the price is so competitive with the other options that are out there. I enjoyed using Squarespace so much that I went ahead and signed up for their affiliate program. So if you liked the looks of what you saw and you want to sign up for Squarespace yourself, then you can support the channel by using the link in the description of this video to sign up for Squarespace. This video is episode number 5 of our free series, Small Business 101. To get access to the entire series, including next week's episode, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you back again here next week.